morning class. Today we are going to look at a poem titled Crossing the Bar, and this is one of the recommended poems, and it's a non-African poem written by Afrechenisi. The poem is already on the board. Sunset and every star, and one clear call for me. And may there be no money of the bar when I put out the sea. Such a tide as moving seems asleep, too full for sand and foam, when that wind drew from out the boundless deep. Toss again, go, twin light and every bed. And after that, the dark, and may there be no sadness farewell when I embark. For though from out are bonds of time and place, the flood may bear me far. I hope to see my pilot face to face when I have crossed the bar. When you look at this poem, you discover that it's a poem that is filled with so much metaphor. It's a metaphorical poem. And this poem compares the passing away to great beyond. That is the crossing of the bar. Passing away from the physical world to the world beyond. That is what we are going to look at in this poem, written by Afrechenisi. Afrechenisi is an English poet who lived in the 18th century. Okay? So it is also a poem that involves a lot of meditation on the imminent death or about the transition to the great beyond. We discovered that the allegorical meaning of the bar that we talk about here, B-A-R, is the barrier between life and death. What separates life from death? So, in this poem, we discovered that the poet was trying to relate or paint a picture of a man who is able to, who is about to translate from this world to the great beyond. A man who is about to die has to cross the bar to reach the other world. So when you look at the first stanza, the first line here says sunset and every star. Yeah, the speaker foresees death, sunset and evening star. As sunset and evening star, he might have realized that his death is very close. And one clear call for me. And one clear call for me. He sees that as a happy and inevitable journey from the limited world to the boundless world unknown. So, death is an assignment which one must undertake. Every man on earth must complete that assignment, according to the poet, Afrechenisi, that death is inevitable. It's an assignment that everyone must carry out. Every man must one day die and leave this planet Earth. So, in this place now, Afrechenisi was trying to relate his personal experience, how he wants his own to be. So he said in this place that one should mourn or wait for him, that no one should mourn or wait for him when he finally dies. And may there not be any money of the bar when I put at the sea. That is what he was trying to relate to us here. And may there be no money of the bar when I put out the sea. Meaning, he's trying to let us know that when he is gone, no one should cry for him. Because he believed that his good deed on earth has placed him in a position where he is going to see his master in the great beyond. He had this foresight that he is going to a place that is better than this present world, according to his poem. So, in stanza 2, we say, such a tide as moving seems too full for sound and foam. So in this stanza, the poet described the process of his dispatcher to the land of the dead. He sees death as the only journey that can only commence when one is asleep. Yes, a child that's moving seems asleep. That is what he means there. Death is a journey that can only happen when one falls asleep, according to the poet. Then there will be full time without sound of the escape of the last breath. Too full of sound and foam. So in this place, the poet is trying to describe the process when human spirit leaves the body and goes to the maker. That is what it means by turn again whole. A process whereby the human spirit leaves the body and goes back to the maker, the one who gives that spirit. Okay? So, in stanza 3, we have it here that begins with the 10th line, and after that, the dark. And may there be no sadness farewell when I am back. So in this stanza, the speaker implores the mourner and sympathizer not to grieve or feel sorrow for him when he is no more. That is what he means by, and may there be no sadness. And may there be no sadness farewell when I am back. Okay? And the journey of no return. The journey of no return here implies the journey to the great beyond, implies death. So, in the last stanza, we discover that the poet reinforces the previous stanza. The poet entreats his relation not to shed tears when he is gone, probably because of his good work on earth, which he strongly believes could earn him a good place. That is the mindset of the poet, that his good work on earth is capable of earning him a better place in the world beyond. That is why he employs his relations, or it might be his friends, not to mourn for him when he finally leaves this sinful world. Okay? For though from out are born of time and place, the flood will bear me far. That is what he means by this. For those from out are born of time and place, the flood may bear me far. Okay? So, we also discover that the poet here sees death as an eternal rest. He will have no fear or repulse as he hopes to meet his pilot face to face when he crosses the bar. The pilot here is representing God, his maker. That when he finally dies, he's going to meet his maker face to face. That is what the poet means by meeting his pilot face to face. Okay? The maker of divine guidance. The speaker is not quite apprehensive in his meeting. The maker. The personnel approaches death as a necessary end. In this world, you will discover that the way he sees death, he did not see it as a harsh encounter or as a harsh experience. He is not apprehensive about death. He sees it as a journey that will transcend from this planet Earth to another world. To him, the world is a better place for those that did well in this planet Earth. So that is what the poem Crossing the Bar by Alfred Tennyson is talking about, and of a great truth, one is bound to leave this planet Earth